is a really special day for me because I'm recreating everything that to me signifies Kerala. When you think Kerala, you think backwaters, you think lush green forests, you think little snake boats. And I'm recreating that magic for myself today. This is a really special recipe for me specifically because one of the few times that I did a touristy Kerala where I sat on a touristy boat and went all around, there was this lovely boatman on that trip of mine who, you know, took us to a local place. He helped us buy fish directly from the waters and he cooked it for us on the boat. So this is my ode to that flavor, to that moment for me specifically. I'm using baby pomfret today, and the reason being that this is the closest that comes to the fish that is available at the backwaters. You get a particular fish called karimeen in the backwaters and it's only available there, nowhere else in the world. So I've got some chopped garlic. Okay, just put it in. Then I've got some chopped ginger. Like I said, this is really simple. It's rustic, it's home. So you can, you know, if you like ginger more, add more ginger. There really isn't a strict structure to be formed around this. My pepper is really peppery, so I'm gonna go slightly easy, but this is also a pepper fry, so you know, I'm not gonna go like really stingy on that either. Just add a little bit of salt. Now remember, the key to this is that you don't make a complete paste out of it. You just want it coarsely ground because you want to be able to bite into the peppercorn as well. So just a little bit of water to sort of just help it all come together. And here we go. I think we can do this one more time, just a little bit. I might have added a little too much water, but no worries. Make sure you've cut a lot of, you know, sort of slices into your fish, like I've done quite a few, but if you are not somebody who likes too much of the masala in between, you can also go easy on it. Like, so just sort of apply it, make sure it gets into your fish, because like I said, this is not, the idea is that you taste the fish with just a little bit of salt and pepper. You're not supposed to be sort of marinating it completely in the masala because it just isn't supposed to be like that. The idea is that you eat the fish and not the masala. So once we've done this, just nicely, like I've also made some slits inside, so I'm just going to stuff like a tiny bit, not too much, because like I said, it's really spicy, so you know, not everybody may be okay with that. So this is our fish that's marinated. Let it stay for a good 15-20 minutes. At this point, you can also sort of, you know, put it in a foil and put it in your freezer. It can also be baked or steamed as well. I like it best when it's fried. So yeah, that's about it. So I'm just gonna go wash my hands and come back because they're already burning. So now just take a thick bottomed pan and heat it up a little bit and add some coconut oil. It tastes nicest with coconut oil. Any other oil just doesn't do it, I feel. I mean, you can't cook Keralite food with regular oil. It just seems wrong to me. I'm going to put some fresh curry leaves. Like, you want the flavor of the curry leaves to sort of seep into the fish. You don't want it to be overpowering. So just into the pan and not into your masala. So now my curry leaves are completely crackled and like slightly crispy. So we're going to put in our fish into the pan right now. Just be careful when you do this because the oil might splutter. And just put it in. It's best to cook it on a slow flame. Just cover it up so that, you know, none of the oil is on you really. And just cook it on a slow flame for a good 5-10 minutes. This fish doesn't take very long to cook. So depending on your pan and on your flame, you could adjust it. I'm just going to check on our fish right now. Oh, it smells beautiful in here. Just be careful not to break the fish. As you can see now, like, we've got a slight crispy skin. Like, the pepper has become like slightly crispy, but we've not burnt the fish. And this is how you want it to be. So it's soft on the inside. Like, I can see white meat on the inside, but it's like a nice crispy golden on the outside. So you want, that's exactly how you want it as well, for it to taste really nice. Yeah. And just cook it on the other side for 5 more minutes. So I think our fish fry is done. You can you can get this wonderful, you know, aroma of the fish and the crispy pepper. And so as you can see, it's like beautifully golden on the outside and it's nice and soft on the inside. So I'm just going to take it out. At this point, if you'd like, you can also take it out on, you know, lay it on a tissue paper or something, just so that there isn't too much oil. But you know, what's a fish fry without a little bit of oil? Okay, so there we go. There are multiple ways to eat it, really. You can eat it with, you know, rice, curry and fish fry on the side with pickle. It'll taste fantastic. Or you can just eat it plain, which is what I'm going to do because it's smelling so good. I cannot possibly wait any longer. And it's exactly what I want it to be. To me, this is Kerala. This is every flavor, every memory. It is that moment on the boat for me. Do try this recipe at home, and if you do, like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel, and please let us know what you think of the recipe.